back in the days when I was a teenager before I had status.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Tabor Talk. So, it's actually not that cold, but it's going to get a whole lot colder. You know, we live in the Catskills here. It's Saturday, November 21st, and boy, do we get killer winters, you know. Freezing here. And by the way, we live in a town that's elevated to begin with, and we live on a mountain in that town, so I'm not going to give the town away for obvious reasons. But anyway, so Joe had a marathon podcast yesterday with Tom Green. I really love Tom Green. He's been on before, and he is one of the pioneers of podcasting, you know, the internet, whatever. He had a show, I'm going to say, like 2002, 2003. So the two real pioneers are Tom Green, and then this guy, Adam Curry, who actually called it a podcast, which was like 2006. Okay, so if you don't know who Tom Green is, he's the guy who was married Drew Barrymore, right? What else was he? He was a comedian back in the 90s. He used to be on Stern for a while. Really interesting guy. Good guy. He's like 49 years old now. He's got kind of long hair and a beard, and he's kind of like a vagabond. He travels the world. He's got this van that he did, and he's doing podcasts. He's got like a drone, and he takes pictures and does videos from his van, and he's just traveling the world, kind of like Jack Kerouac shit. Really fucking cool. I'm really jealous of him, actually. I'd love to do that. Someday, who knows? Not with this COVID shit, but actually, he's managing to do it. So, okay. So, marathon of a podcast, 4.5 hours long. I liked it a lot because I like Tom Green. A little annoying, Joe repeats himself. Listen, I've been following Joe since 2009, right? His very first podcast, Christmas Eve, 2009. He and Brian Redman in his basement, whatever. And I've listened to almost all of them, up to 1,400. So listen, I've been listening to Joe for thousands of hours. I've heard every one of his stories many times, many, many times, and it is annoying. But the thing is, I'm hard on him because I know, I probably know Joe better than he knows himself, you know? When the first time I heard the stories, they were great. They were fresh and all this, but he fucking repeats himself. And by the way, he does add stuff because Joe's, what the awesome thing about Joe is he's a very curious guy. He's like me. He reads everything. He's interested in absolutely everything. You know, look at his podcast. He has comedians and scientists and authors and politicians and actors, and he's got everything in there, and he's interested in, you know, technology and AI, everything. And he's not an expert in anything except for martial arts. He is an expert. Okay. So couple of things that annoy me about Joe is that he does repeat himself. But okay, that's fine. I'm a different person because I've heard them all. The new person might enjoy them because they are pretty good. What I don't like is that he always says he's a moron. He always says, I'm an idiot. I'm a moron. Don't listen to me. And you like the humility. That's for sure. And he isn't an expert in a lot of things except for martial arts. Definitely a clever guy. But I've heard that 100 times. I'm a moron. Don't listen to me. So I finally posted in the comments section of that podcast. I go, so first of all, let me just say this. So he said it, and then Tom Green goes, dude, you're not a fucking moron. You're not a moron. You're like smarter than 90% of the population. Now, are you an expert in some of these fields? You know, like, I don't know, French existentialism? I don't know. Maybe not. But you're smarter than the average duck, if you will. So, and I wrote here, I go, I agree with Tom. It's annoying when Rogan says he himself, I put in parentheses, is a moron. It's annoying when he says he's a moron. Moron. Listen. 10.1 million subscribers, number one podcast in the world, etc. And I said, I personally wouldn't waste my time listening to a moron's podcast. And then I went on to say, is it false modesty? Is Joe just saying that? And I say, think it's that. And I said, but it is quite annoying. And I wish he would stop saying it. There are a lot of comments here. A lot of people didn't like him. Let's see. This guy says, he says that as an excuse to avoid responsibility for the outrageous things he says. He definitely does not believe he himself is a moron. He talks like a pompous know-it-all most of the time. There are a lot of comments here. So this guy says, I think it's possibly because he feels a burden of responsibility to the simple-minded who take what he says as verbatim. Okay, blah, blah, blah. So my wife says, why do you continue to listen to Joe? You know, because I am so annoyed. I don't find him really entertaining anymore. I listen to him because of his guests. Like, he's got these amazing guests, and there's something, Joe has able to bring out something that others don't. And I'm telling you, like, it really is. It's an educational show. I'm not interested in the drinking and smoking pot and laughing and joking. I don't even think Joe's a particularly good comic either. So I'm not listening to him for the entertainment purposes, you know, whatever. It really is the guess. And then Joe is a very honest, candid guy. Although he was annoying me going after this anti-Biden thing. It was fucking disgusting. You know, and really low life, like going after his age and stuttering and the whole idea that he doesn't know where he is. Dude, Joe Biden's a very smart guy. Is he eloquent? No. Does he stutter a little bit? But listen to the content of his stuff. He's not fucking, he doesn't have dementia. That's so wrong, and it's so fucking adolescent. You know, like I used to say to people who would say that, this stupid, you know, the stupid lies, take the transcripts of, say, like a Trump speech and Biden, right? Trump is like, oh, these fragments and, you know, tremendous, tremendous, you know, he wasn't saying anything. So, all right, I'm not going to get into that. So, you know, why do I listen to him? It's because he has a good show, all right? Is Joe a great interview? He's very good, you know? And I've been listening to, Tabor Talk. I listen to all these shows. I love guys like Charlie Rose. You know, I wish Charlie was, but he's old now anyway, and he got in trouble with the Me Too movement. He loved the women too much, right? But a great, great interview, Charlie Rose. I like Phil Donahue. And I can't, the top of my head, I'm just, you know, all right, I'll talk about that more some other day. So what do you think? Is Joe Rogan a moron? Is he annoying? What do you think? All right. Tabor Talk. Good friends, good books, and a sleepy conscience. I have a new theme song, by the way. Playing around with it. It's kind of cool. All right. Peace, man.